Brother, why do car guys lose their minds over Toyota JZ engines? It's just a six-cylinder, right?
Just a six-cylinder? Case kitty. The JZ is basically Japan's middle finger to engine limits.
Okay, what makes it so special?
First, you've got the one JZ, 2.5-liter, inline-six, factory twin-turbo, revs happy, built like a tank. Then the big brother, the two JZ, 3-liter, and it can handle over 800 horsepower on stock internals.
Wait, 800 horsepower without opening it up?
Yep. Strong iron block, forged crank. Beefy rods. You throw in bigger turbos, more fuel, and it just says, is that all you got?
Was it fast stock?
Stock? Decent. But the magic is in tuning. The 2JZ GTE was in the Supra, rated around 276 horsepower because of Japan's gentleman's agreement. But everyone knows it's underrated.
And that's why people put them in everything?
Exactly. Drift cars, drag cars, even boats. If you want reliable big power, you call the JZ.
What about the sound?
Oh, that straight six sings. High-pitched, angry. Turbo spool and wastegate chatter for days.
But why is it so reliable?
Over-engineered. Toyota wanted it to last forever even under boost. The cooling, oiling, everything is just solid.
So it's basically the engine you get if you want to build a monster without it exploding.
Yep. It's the reason you see Supras doing 1,000 horsepower runs and still daily driving to the shop.
JZ isn't just an engine. It's a lifestyle.
Exactly, Keisuke.